Thank you, Cordella, for the introduction, and thanks for welcoming us along with Alana and all your incredible staff here at the YMCA for your support. I'm happy to be here with Dan, with Kevin and Terry, who are all strong voices from Manitoba and across the country. Good to see Premier Stephenson. Always nice to make announcements with you, Heather, and Provincial Minister Owasco and other colleagues. Today is a great reminder of what we can do when we all work together to deliver for families and for folks in Manitoba and across the country. I just spent 2 weeks doing different town halls with Canadians across the country. I met with nurses, workers, PSWs, students, farmers, among others. I listened to them and answered a few questions. And obviously, one of the things that keeps coming back for Canadians across the country is concerns about the rising cost of living. Avec la pandémie et avec l'invasion de la Russie en Ukraine, on a vu une accélération de la hausse du coût de la vie. Beaucoup de familles ont de la difficulté à payer leurs factures. C'est pour ça qu'on a pris des mesures pour aider les gens qui en ont le plus besoin. We doubled the GST credit for 6 months for roughly 11 million households. Eligible couples with two kids got up to an extra $467 back in their pockets, and eligible seniors got about $225 on average. We're fighting climate change with a price on pollution that is giving back more money than most people pay. A family of four here in Manitoba will get over $1,000 back this coming fiscal year through climate action incentive payments. We enhanced the Canada Workers' Benefit, which means workers can receive up to $1,200 more this year. We're delivering payments of an extra $500 for people who are struggling with the cost of rent. We launched the Canada Dental Benefit that has helped more than 220,000 kids whose families couldn't afford to send them to the dentist go to the dentist so far. And of course, we're continuing our work to make childcare more affordable right across the country, including here in Manitoba. Today, we're here together to announce that Manitoba will achieve an average of $10 a day for regulated childcare in a few weeks on April 2nd, 3 years ahead of schedule. We just met with a number of parents here at the YMCA. For example, Brenda and Peter told me they're now saving hundreds of dollars a month, which are savings that can be used for groceries, other bills, or after-school activities, and it's making a real difference in their lives. This is part of our plan to make life more affordable for the middle class and for people working hard to join it. It's part of our plan to build an economy that works for all Canadians. Les parents, et en particulier les mères, ne devraient pas avoir à choisir entre leur famille et leur carrière. Quand les garderies sont plus abordables, c'est bon pour les familles, et c'est aussi bon pour l'économie, parce que ça permet à plus de parents de faire partie du marché du travail. We're keeping our promise to make childcare more affordable. Today's announcement for $10 a day childcare in Manitoba comes less than 2 years after we reached an agreement with the province. And of course, all of this work wouldn't be possible without the advocacy and leadership of the childcare sector. So to all the experts, educators, providers, and families who've been tireless in advocating for better childcare for years, indeed for decades, thank you for your continued work. As you know, we have agreements with all provinces and territories to make childcare more affordable for families. We're seeing results here in Manitoba and across the country. Families in nearly half of provinces and territories are now benefiting from an average of $10 a day or less. That includes both Quebec and the Yukon, who have led the country in delivering affordable childcare. And fees have been cut in half in all other provinces and territories, with work on track to deliver $10 a day childcare everywhere across the country by March 2026. But now in April in Manitoba. On continue notre travail pour rendre la vie plus abordable. En étant là pour soutenir la classe moyenne et ceux qui travaillent fort pour s'y joindre, on bâtit une économie centrée sur le bien-être de tous les gens au Manitoba et de tous les Canadiens.